Hey guys, this is Luigi Rocks 2014 bringing you part 23 of Super Mario Odyssey. Today we're going to continue with Bowser's Kingdom Castle thing. Yeah, Bowser's Castle. By, of course, randomly getting hit for no reason. Yep, because, you know, I'm just so bad at this stupid... with these annoying little bombs here. Alright, yep, there's a heart there that we can get. Alright, so... oh yeah, and here at this part, I was gonna go upwards, but I decided to backtrack because, there was a power moon that was in the underwater area that I missed. So I decided to go down there and grab it. Pretty sure it doesn't have to be this, or yeah, actually it has to be this side. As far as I recall, there was only one power moon in this area, so... yep, so I just go over here and grab this. Sunken treasure in the moat, and then... basically continue upwards. So yeah, pretty much I do end up collecting quite a lot of power moons in this kingdom, and a lot of purple coins too. So yeah, grab this guy and then we're gonna make our way back up to the top. Yeah, I would not honestly say that we're anywhere close to finishing this game. Because, if I'm being truthfully honest, there's actually one more kingdom after Bowser's Castle that we have to go to. And you might be thinking, what? The final boss isn't here at Bowser's Castle? And, well, I'm sorry to say it, guys. I mean, it's not. That's not how Nintendo... wanted the game to end, apparently. So now the question is, how does the game end? Well, you'll just have to wait and find out. Yeah, because pretty much after this video, there's only like two more parts left before this walkthrough is like officially over. Yeah, because like, when we get to, like, the next kingdom, I'm not really sure what exactly happens, but I think the next kingdom, I don't think I ended up collecting as many power moons as I normally would have. Most likely due to the fact that I just didn't want to keep spending so much time dicking around trying to collect all the power moons, so I decided to just try to focus on the prime objectives instead. Because it was at the point where the walkthrough was already starting to last up to 25 parts, and I didn't really want it going into 30 parts because, yeah, it was just, like, too much, basically. So, yeah, that's basically why I'm not actually going to be, probably not going to be collecting as many power moons in the next kingdom after this one. I mean, if I'm lucky, maybe I'll find a lot, but if not, oh well. Yeah, I'm not really expecting to find a whole lot of power moons in this kingdom. So yeah. Alright, so... yeah, these little ogre statues, we could... well, I'm just gonna avoid these guys. So you want to use the bird enemy that you collected and make your way up to the top. I was going to go to the left, but then I decided, no, I want to go to the right. But here's where the bullshit actually started. Basically here at this part, I kept screwing up trying to get to the purple coins here, and it was like nothing but a series of failures. As I had said previously, you know, controlling the bird creature thing might actually look easy, but truth be told, it's harder than it looks. I don't know if I'm the only one that's just been having this problem, like if I'm just having a skill issue of not being able to control this son of a bitch. Okay, that time definitely was a skill issue, because yeah, there should have been no reason why that even had to happen. But yeah, I don't know exactly how I screwed this up, but yeah, we'll just try to avoid this ogre statue thing. Whatever you really want to call it, I don't really care. And again, with these stupid glitches, it's like, literally I'm calling it a glitch because it's so annoying that I can't even get up there. Because like the one time I tried grabbing on the wall and it wouldn't let me. Like, see, it's just so stupid. It's like, how do I expect to grab the wall if I'm having to, if I can't face the wall itself? Like, that's just so stupid. Okay, that time I should have stayed on that part of the wall, because yeah, by not doing that, I missed the purple coin. So yeah, I definitely want to stay on the more on the like topper right path thing. Because yeah, now see here, I only collected only two purple coins, and now I have to go back and grab the other one. Yeah, these ogre statues are just annoying. I could get rid of it, but I don't give enough of a shit to care at this point. That's literally just how I felt when I recorded this. At least that's what I kind of remembered. I just wasn't giving enough of a shit to get rid of that statue. So, the argument could probably be that, yeah, I was just attempting to cheese the level once again. And obviously, you know, my attempt at cheesing these levels don't always get me anywhere. Maybe in other games it might, but definitely not this one. Okay, so there's some purple coins here, which luckily I did manage to land on them. Yeah, I just decided to ride this platform, or the spinning thing around, just because I didn't feel like wasting time trying to do the stupid, annoying jump thing. Oh yeah, and this is where more BS starts to happen, climbing up those walls. I decided to go into the souvenir shop right now when I probably should have just waited till I got to the boss, but whatever. Yep, got the lantern. Yeah, I'm just gonna keep buying more of the souvenirs. I need the samurai suit and the helmet for sure, which you'll see later on why that is. Inner wall, yep, that's the one we want. Luckily, it does give you a lot of checkpoints to teleport to. Okay, let's do this. Come on. There we go. Yeah, there's not really a whole lot left to do. Yep, at this part here, I was being really stupid. Oh yeah, this is... okay. Yeah, you want to get the purple coins on the left. I don't think there were any more on the right, so I just decided to skip that and just move onwards. Yep, just more purple water down there that we don't want to fall into. Because, you know, it's not enough that Bowser couldn't have lava, but instead wanted poison water instead. I suspect he just uses that for one of his minions, I guess. I don't know. Yeah, I was gonna head over there, but I just didn't really felt like it because I didn't see anything over there that would be useful. Okay, now actually before we go into the electric zipline thing, we want to head over here. Yeah, there's an 8-bit cat peach with hearts, which I'm not getting. Alright, so what we want to do is try to insert the beacon through that little hole. Big hole, I should say. Which apparently was not working out so great. Because every time I jumped, I always did it too early. There we go. Nice. Poking your nose by the Great Gate. Doesn't look so great to me, but sure. Yep, I didn't have myself lined up there very good. This one's really just nothing but coins. If you really need coins, you can get it. Me personally, I just don't see the point, so yeah. Okay, yeah, we'll just go ahead and get out of this bird enemy and just go into the electric zip line. Now, this part here, I wanted to try to find a life heart thing, but when I tried jumping over to the other side, the cutscene just ended up activating anyways. So that didn't really work out so great. Yep. Wow, really? This idiot's not even gonna try to face me himself? That's right, the last kingdom is going to be literally on the moon. Wow, you'd think you'd learn from last time about that thing he has on his hat, but nope. Mario's just too stupid to realize that. But, yeah, okay, sorry about that. I got interrupted, so I just decided to stop the audio for a second there. Alright, yep. The Boodles are back again. This time we have their little machine thing to destroy. Wow, okay, sure. So pretty sure what you have to do is you have to throw the bombs onto their legs for you to be able to climb up top. There we go. Yep, just climb up top. Yep, just use the pecker bird thing to break open their little glass shield thing, I guess. I don't know. Glass, their little cover. I don't even know if it's made of glass, to be honest. Oh shit. Oh shit, okay. What are you doing? Come on. Wow, really? Gosh. This is one thing I always hated about this fight. Was sometimes I try to hit their little glass, or their little dome cover thing, their cockpit or whatever, and stupid thing would not even work half the times. Okay, so now the thing's running out of control. I'm pretty sure this is a boss fight that requires like more than one hit or something like that, so yeah, this is going to be quite a long fight. But yeah, I think this video only ended up being 18 minutes long because, yeah, I think I did this fight and then I think I pretty much called it good after this recording. Like, I decided to just start the Moon Kingdom, like, in the next recording session. Yeah, and those little spinny things won't even have any effect on their legs. So yeah, we'll just have to wait until they fall over. There we go. Oh my gosh. This is where it gets really annoying, is that, you know, there's certain parts you can't even, like, hit. There we go. Yes, we can. Yep, so we just gotta keep, you know, just focus on defeating these guys, and then, you know, we'll pretty much be calling it good after this. Okay, wow, another failure, seriously? Yeah, if you can't hit their legs, the legs on their machine at least two times, then yeah, you have to go through this crap again. Again, really? Really? That should have just counted as two hits anyways. Like, what the heck? Yeah, I look back at this and it half the times even looking at this now, it just doesn't even make sense. Like, this fight is just so stupid. Yeah, at this point, I probably would have just rather take the L at this point. Yep. Grab a heart. Probably wasn't the smartest idea, because now all I'm doing is wasting more time. Is this actually it? Like, are we done? Okay. Yep, looks like we're done. So I think just like that, that's the end of the Boodles. Maybe. I mean, just based on those symbols, I would say it is. And yep, we got a multi-power moon thing, so yep. That's pretty much gonna be it, I think, for the Bowser Kingdom, and I think the next two videos, I think I'm gonna be going into the Moon Kingdom. So I think all that I end up doing is, like, I think I end up collecting maybe a few more Power Moons after this, if not one more, and then decide, and then I ended up calling it good, but, yeah. Yeah, because, you know, the Odyssey can technically travel onto the, can travel into space. Yeah, this is kind of part of the reason why I feel like this game kind of became just the closest thing to the closest Super Mario Galaxy 3. Yep, I'm gonna buy the samurai armor. I don't know why I hit maybe later, because I'm gonna need it. Whatever. Yeah, because I think there's a power moon that, like I said, that requires the samurai outfit. Yeah, there's nothing else in here. I'm not getting a life heart for 50 coins, because again, that's not worth it. So yeah, I think that's it for this video, guys. So thank you all for watching. Please rate, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to join the Discord down below, and I'll see you guys next time when we head into the Moon Kingdom. Later, guys.